A mild-mannered professor moonlighting as a fake contract killer sparks a chain reaction of trouble when he falls for a client. Directed by Richard Linklater and co-written by star Glenn Powell, Hitman showcases the best of each creator's abilities. It is a great sadness that this is not getting a wide theatrical release because Hitman is one of the best films of the year. Glenn Powell officially has the sauce. He shined with Top Gun Maverick in 2022, which gave just a glimpse into the movie star he is meant to be. Hitman presents the audience with many different sides to Powell's role as Gary Johnson as he transforms into a cast of hitmen trying to frame the people hiring him until he meets a beautiful woman played by Adria Adorna. Powell is his best here, and I'm not surprised he co-wrote the film with Linklater because he crafted a truly entertaining script. He gets to shine as he plays a variety of goofy characters with subtle and quick scenes, with the main role showcasing a great dichotomy between nerdy yet confident. Adorna, who plays an upset wife trying to put a hit on her husband, is the sexiest role I have ever seen, embodying a heartthrob to her core. With every scene, she presents herself as provocative yet intimidating, always making the viewer question if she is to be trusted. I was blown away by her performance, not only because I was hot and bothered more than I have ever been, but due to the fact that she gives a very convincing performance with much nuance. Last time I was this entranced by an actress was Linda Cardellini as Velma in Scooby-Dooby 2. God, what I would give. Everyone else's supporting roles were also phenomenal. Their addition to the movie heightened the stakes at every turn. I particularly was a fan of Austin Emilio's role as Jasper. Being a cop who is not liked, but also just trying to do his job, was better than the typical hitman on the hitman crime drama you would expect. Every small role of someone soliciting a hitman to kill a significant other, business partner, or someone they hated was a great fun to watch. Gary Johnson was a real man, and this movie plays off his true life accomplishments. They of course embellished some things here and there, which they are not afraid to admit in the end, and ended up being a fun way to end the film. I love the concept of a fake hitman running sting operations to catch real-life criminals. It was a unique idea to play with, and I think Linklater and Powell came up with the best version possible. One little gripe my friend and I had was the lighting in some scenes were so overbearing, it seemed overtly fake. Classrooms, diners, they were so overblown, you could tell it was likely a big studio light unless it was a very sunny day. It didn't ruin my experience, but it didn't go unnoticed. Another thing that didn't go unnoticed was the sexiness of the entire film. Hitman breathes sex appeal, and like I said, I was getting chills during this movie. It takes everything an audience will love about a romantic comedy and turns the dial up to 100. Hitman is the epitome of a romantic comedy mixing the best parts of a thriller drama taboo. I appreciated the little scenes with Powell as the professor as he progressively changed into a more confident character throughout the movie. Those little nuances added a lot to this. Adorna may have been the typical love interest, but she acted the hell out of her role and gave me doubt the entire time, asking myself, is she crazy or is she just extremely hot? Netflix is doing a disservice to so many movies by not only refusing to release physical media, but not giving theatrical runs for these big-time directors that have a known audience. Linklater deserves more, and so does Glenn Powell, a clear movie star in his own right. I hope this blows up on Netflix because it needs to be seen and loved. Hitman had a lot of praise coming out of the film festivals, and I am happy that a movie with such glowing reviews lived up to my expectations.
Who is your Hitman? We'll see.
Hold up, please don't let me be misunderstood.
Tune in every Friday for new movie videos. Please like, share, and subscribe. Comment down below what other movies you would like me to do videos on. Thank you, Mom, for editing the scripts for my movie essays. I appreciate you. Till next time, thanks for watching. Catch you on the flip side.